Hello, fellow kindled, welcome back. Last time, we began our trek through Archdragon Peak and took on Ancient Wyvern, and died like 3 times. Now, we're gonna continue our exploration. Oh! Shit. We gotta kill that sorcerer. It doesn't drop anything. Well, it has a chance of dropping a staff, which gives you more souls. Soul of a Crestfallen Knight. And that's a Drakeblood Knight. Remember him from Dark Souls 2 in the DLC Sucking King? Yeah, I was crowded the Sucking King. Now, you defeat this one the first time? Well, and get the Drakeblood Greatsword. And for those who play Dark Souls 2, you'll remember, it's the only Greatsword that actually has multiple split damage. 18 strength, 16 dex requirements. Why does it have some sort of int scaling? Because it looks like the number... there's a minus sign next to the it requirement bonus. Physical, magic, lightning damage. There's our bonfire. Now, we use Path of the Dragon Gesture down here, we'll get a ring. Yep, the Calamity Ring. For those who remember Calamity from Dark Souls 2, 1. Shit, I'm sorry. Remember Black Dragon Calamity? Yep. Guy's ring. Means we receive double damage. I'm trying to figure out why you'd want that ring. Maybe you like living on the edge or something? Oh! Oh shit. So if you're wondering, that does look a lot like a crystal lizard. I think they're like the prototype of the crystal lizard. Oh, got tight head skill. And yes, it has that annoying tendency to knock you off of ledges. Maritime scale. Okay. So this is a much bigger area than I initially figured. Now we go over this gate and we get the Dragon Slayer Spear. That's right, Ornstein's weapon. Which kind of gives a hint that he may have died here. 20 strength, 20 dex. Surprisingly, no faith requirement. But it's got D for faith scaling, so. If you're looking for this, this is where you find it. I'm pretty sure you upgrade with dragon scales. Tidehat scales. Let's see, we could go down here. But we can also go back up. Okay, shortcut. Oh, ambush. Tidehat scale. So that's pretty much all the tidehat scales this area is worth for. Ugh. Oh, shortcut. Yeah, remember this. There's your convenient shortcut to the first bonfire. Cow meat. Actually, it looks like the ancient wyvern. Matter of fact, we saw something similar to the ancient wyvern in the High Wall of Lothric. Oh, we got invaded. At least I'm pretty sure that's what just happened. Okay, where's our invader? Yeah, ambush ahead. So that's a sizable amount of fall damage. Oh yeah, I remember this. This is where we encountered the one creature. Okay. It's apparently obvious I have no idea where I am. Where is the invader? Because, frankly, I prefer not to go through the rest of the area if it means having to deal with invader. I don't think they're up there. Yes. I remember this. This is the ladder where we used to kill the ancient dragon. Well, the ladder from which... The ladder we went up to get to the point where we could plunge attack the ancient dragon. Ancient wyvern. God. I know there's a difference between wyvern and dragon, but... Ow! Okay, their heads can go through walls. That hurts. And that was not the spell I was trying to use. Where is the invader? I know at some point the invader's gonna attack me. Hi, Piggy! Run out! Oh shit. Yes! We did it! We killed it! Please tell me whoever invaded me decided, nah, screw it, I'm out. Because that'd be nice. Praise the bright spot. Because I'm guessing there's an item around here. No, there's not an item around here. Yay! Fear of heights. I know I'm gonna get screwed at some point. I'm just wondering when. And probably how. We walk over here. We walk over here. Got to work with tonight. Oh, good, it's not Mimic. I know I said several times that that was the last Mimic, or that was the last Mimic. It's more of, I usually can't remember. And the DLC will probably have Mimics, because, well, of course it will. Oh wow, I didn't notice you. I call those proto crystal lizards. Why? I mean, come on, they look like the original crystal lizard, just slightly bigger. Hi, dragon! Yep. You kill that, it gives you a lot of good upgrade materials. Let's equip our binoculars. Okay, where... Yeah, we got the head and torso stone. Where is our stupid host? Unless whoever invaded me decided, screw it, I'm out. Which case, that'd be nice. Okay, hit him by the neck. Hopefully it stays here. My god, this is easy. I mean, you could try meleeing it, but... Honestly, nah. Gives us 6 tie-dye chucks, 3 tie-dye scales, 3 twinkling tie nuts. I keep hearing that noise, which is telling me, hey! You've got stone lizards. Technically they're called stone lizards, but I call them crystal lizard prototype. Trick again, because this is going to be fun. Ah, Twinkly Titanite. So I think you could farm this Twinkly Titanite stuff here. Yeah, this looks like a sniper spot to deal with the stupid dragon. And also another sniper spot to deal with said dragon. God, this place has way too much sun. I'm used to the whole Dark Souls. Oh my god, this is depressing shit. We're about to have Snake Loman summon something else to deal with. Ow. We're just gonna wait for... She summoned an NPC that has Rickard's Rapier. So, here's where you get Rickard's Rapier from. Ow. Oh, come on! Ow! There we go, that works. I believe that was an alternate version of King Rickard himself, or Prince Rickard. Yeah, undead Prince Rickard. H strength, 20 dex, so I'm guessing kind of a dex weapon. We have to be careful about our magic now. Oh, she can summon more of them. Shit. Okay, lure him back. As far as I know, I don't think you get anything else from him again. Except for 4,000 souls. It's around 4,000. You can use the one we fought at the beginning of this episode. Have her keep summoning the Drakeblood Knight. Come on. Do I need to use Praise the Sun gesture? That's right. First time we praise the sun. And, of course, nothing happens. Delightful. Oh, no. Let's not fall to our deaths. Because that would be stupid. Yeah, we were here before. Travel the path of the dragon, do not ring the great bell. This unlocks our last boss fight. Ringing that bell. But there are items we're gonna get. Which, convenient bonfire. I believe this is the last bonfire area, but we're gonna have to sneak past shit and kill shit. Large Soul of Crestfall Knight, kill these two. There's nothing over here. But there are some things over here. Ember. That's it. Oh, I actually figured this episode would be longer. Then again, nothing over there. Unless the sunlight blinded me to where I missed it. Oh, damn it! Yes! It died. But we got Twiglet tied up. So I feel happy. Because we didn't die to stupid rock lizard. Or crystal lizard prototype. Now, up here we fight Havel himself. That's right. It's the one, the only, Havel the Rock. Now, I remember that dragon's dead. And Havel's got significant magic defense. Awesome. Tie that slab. So here's another tie that slab. Ow, ow, ow. Bad idea. Bad idea. Let's see if this works. Ah, no, 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 no! No! Shit! Wow. That was my fault. I totally forgot you could be poise stunned all hell. That literally happens far too often. It's like, oh, you could destroy him. Well, considering we got shit for Vigor, hold on. Now we're gonna kill the stupid lizard, because... Ow! Okay! I underestimated that lizard. That's the annoying part. The hole. Button. Headbutt. 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 Oops, you're falling off a cliff now. It's dead. And Havel round two. Delightful. And I'd say I should have equipped my longsword and crystal buffed it. But... Oh! He becomes Havel the Rock God! And he's dead now. So we got Dragon Tooth and Havel's Great Shield. If I remember, Havel's Great Shield is the most powerful Great Shield in the game. 40 strength to wield it. But it's also got really high all-around defenses and high stability. Let's see, what else is I missing? Oh yeah, the Dragon Tooth. Okay, where's the stupid Dragon Tooth? Okay, 40 strength. Got respectable-ish defenses, high stability. And of course it'll never break. I could swear there was a miracle around here. Oh, I think that's for the other wyvern. And we already killed it. I swear there was a miracle around here. Shit. The hell? I wasn't even close to you! Okay. That hit him. Okay, he put most of his points into fight. Get. Okay, you did hit me. I hit you several times. Really? That hit him. Okay. And that was Netcode that kicked my butt. We came close several times. Well, we did. Oh god, we have to go for that stupid lizard again. Oh. Two times the charm. And we're gonna amber up again, cause... better not to take chances like we did with the whole Lothric-Lorien fight. What a crystal soul spirit, a stupid lizard. Only drops, only gives you 150 souls. And again, souls are like candy nowadays. I could swear there was a miracle around here. I could be remembering wrong. But this next part's gonna be fun. And by fun, I mean shitty. And by shitty, well, typical Dark Souls fanfare, per se. Oh, we can summon Hawkwind for this area. Okay. The next part's gonna probably suck, cause there's a bunch of them. They're gonna come through. Large side-out shard. I feel like I'm hearing something. Buffer staff. I believe that's all of them. little bastard. Aside from how beautiful this area is, that's one of the things I hate about it. Because you have to find something for every Dark Souls area to hate. In my case, it's the ones with the axe. The ones that can toss their axe like it's a toy. Oh, got so we can turn that. And over here is Dragon Chaser's Ashes. Dragon Chaser's Ashes. Ugh. So that's the last ashes that we'll get pre-DLC? Now, or now you'd have to run out past here. That's actually quite easy to do, because most of the enemies won't mess with you once you get to a certain point up here. Time for a gesture to let there be item. And we get the Twinkling Dragon Torso Stone. Because I didn't even notice that before. You look over there, that's a dragon. A very big, very dead dragon. I mean, seriously, the thing's almost the size of a mountain itself. Alright, so let's get out of this dump. This is actually longer than my last one. Mainly the fact that we died twice. That's probably why.
Ashbel, then I am of the house. Very then take.
Just level me up, please. There we go.
Mayst thou.
Just gotta put more points in. Fight! More points into vitality. Then we'll be at level 100.
Gracious letter.
Now, as for exactly what else really changes, see? Turn that scales, you can buy them infinitely. Problem is, you have to pay 20,000 souls a pop. And Twinkly Tine Hut. Reinforced weapons to plus 4, 15,000. Infinite maladies for 13. And just one for 30,000 for a 10-night slab. Try to figure out what new armors we get. No. 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 Yeah, I was wrong. Maybe we don't get new armors from the dragon thing. Let's buy that.
Ashen one.
And let's make ourselves not look like a hollow. Let's frankly, the next episode is probably going to be the shortest one, depending. Basically, it'll be us taking on a boss, grabbing the rest of the items after the boss, then dealing with one more person. Actually, let's buy both of those. Got three of them. Hey, no, I think we're good this episode. Alright, fold that out of the way, we're done for this episode. Well, guess I'll see you all next time as we take on the last boss of the game, pre-DLC. DLC, I think, gives us like two extra bosses to mess with. So, see you all then, praise the sun, praise the moon, praise whatever, bye-bye.